Hello, everybody. Is my head cut off? There. Perfect. I never know how to start. What is that? Oh, this is totally in the frame. There we go. Oh my gosh, I'm not, am I recording audio? Yes, I am. Hi everybody, it's me, it's Krystina Alabado. I'm back with a new beverage, a nice coffee with Simply Straws. Hashtag Simply Straws, love them. And it's pink, it's so cute. And a new featured plant. This is my plant for my dressing room. I don't have a name for her, though Erica gave me this plant for my debut as Gretchen, so I now name this plant Erica Henningsen. Thanks, Erica. Anyway, I'm back. I am so happy with the response that was to my video yesterday. Thank you all for liking it and subscribing and also just like watching it in general because that meant a lot to me and I had fun making it. So I'm gonna just keep making them because it's fun. And what else am I supposed to do? And also I wanna chat and talk. So this video I'm dedicating to Mean Girls. I just kind of wanted to chat. I'm just gonna sort of talk. I wanted to talk about Mean Girls and everything that happened and how I'm feeling about the coronavirus and what happened with the Broadway shutdown and what all my thoughts are about that. So it has been an incredibly strange 5 days. So I'm counting this as day 5 because we got the shutdown notice and then I counted day 1 as the next day. So I'm counting this as day 5 of Broadway shutdown, though you could technically say it's day 6. The whole thing was insane, and we had started like feeling it a little bit at the theater. I wonder what's gonna start happening with our shows, especially like last week, which I guess the week before the shutdown, I remember at the theater, we were like, this is feeling strange now. Something big is gonna happen. I wonder if we're gonna keep doing our shows. And of course we kept doing them as much as we could. And the last thing we wanted to do was stop, but safety is the most important. But it was so interesting. Like we came off of a high. You guys know, Mean Girls had like a huge couple of weeks. So let's go back to before this coronavirus thing happened. We had an incredibly jam-packed Mean Girls for the last month. First, we said goodbye to Erica Henningsen, the OG Katie, my heart, my soul, my bestie, this plant, it was so insane to say goodbye to her because she is like the freaking heartbeat of our theater and of Mean Girls. But we said goodbye to her so she could fly on over to Lincoln Center to do Flying Over Sunset. So that's sort of how these weeks started with that. And then we slowly started saying goodbye to everybody else. And on March 8th, which was just a couple of days before the shutdown, we said goodbye to Kate Rockwell, my roomie, my show wife, my scene partner, my Karen. We said goodbye to Barrett Wilbert Weed and Gray Henson, whom I love so much. I love all of our OBCs, and it was so difficult to say happy trails to them. You know, what's funny about Broadway and doing theater, and you all know from your shows at school, from shows you've done, you say goodbye and it is gut-wrenching and so crazy and so different. And you're like, what's happening? Everything's all up in the air. But then you get to say hello to a bunch of incredible new cast members. They get to start the journey of Mean Girls. I mean, that was me last year when I started as Gretchen. I was coming into a company that was going and I was the one new person to come in. And I was embraced with open arms, but after also saying goodbye and happy trails and we love you to Ashley Park and everything in the legacy she left behind. So it's so interesting. Theater is such like a revolving door. It's in and out, and it's also like we say goodbye and we say farewell, but then we say welcome, and I'm so excited for you to all of the new people. We said hello to Sabrina Carpenter as the new Katie Heron. Sabrina, I can't wait for you all to see her when we come back. She is insanely amazing. The sweetest person ever. We welcome Laura Lee Turner as our new Karen Smith and my new roomie, Chad Burris, our brand new Damien. So kind, so sweet, so hardworking. And we said, of course, hello. Well, we said hello on the second floor to Olivia Kaufman, who was our standby for Katie, Janice, and the adult woman, and is now Janice full-time. She's incredible. Truly, my heart could not be more happy for her. We also said hello to Lily Kaufman making her Broadway debut, people. Broadway debut. I can't imagine what they're feeling right now because it must be crazy to do 3 shows of a brand new Broadway musical and then to be like, just kidding, you have to take 4 weeks off. Okay, so we said goodbye to everyone. We said hello to everyone on Tuesday. It was incredible to celebrate. But not only that, we started a new version of Mean Girls on Tuesday. We had been in tech and rehearsals for the last 2 weeks working on new jokes, different scenes, different songs, different choreography, changing up the show to match the tour changes that went in when the tour went out. And so it was these 2 weeks of concentrated insanity. We were rehearsing a different show than we were doing at night for 2 weeks. So our brains were like, oh! But it was so fun and it brought us together and it made our new cast come together. So it's just so awesome. So on Tuesday, we got to celebrate starting the new show, not only for all of us that had been doing it for the last year, but also for our brand new people. We got to have a party and we had our lay and repeat because I totally made a janky step and repeat and I took it to this place that we went for our party and they wouldn't let me tape it on the wall, which like I kind of get, they didn't want the paint to chip, but I was like, come on guys, just one little piece of tape. And they were like, absolutely not. And so I said, fine, I'm gonna put it on the floor and we're gonna lay on it, lay and repeat. You can check out the lay and repeat on my Instagram and other people's. For Wednesday to happen, to do two shows, so we've done three shows with the new cast and the new show, and then for Thursday to come and for us to get shut down, I still truly like haven't quite processed like what that is, what has happened, that I'm here at 4 o'clock drinking my coffee, chilling out. I think one of the weirdest things that happened with the shutdown is that things changed really fast, and it ended up accidentally being a couple of people in Mean Girls' final show, which is so weird. We didn't get to properly say goodbye, so I would like to properly say goodbye to them via this YouTube channel. The first person that had their last show and they didn't know they were gonna have their last show was Maria Briggs. I could talk about Maria Briggs for an entire video. She is the most incredible swing I have ever known. She is kind, works her butt off, is insanely talented. She is literally at 150% all the time, every show, every track she goes on for. She's also been in like 45,000 Broadway shows. Congratulations on an incredible run in Mean Girls, and on to the next. I'm so excited for you. The second person we said goodbye to without knowing was Darius Barnes. Darius covered Damien and was in our ensemble, and this man, I can't say enough about him. He is also, again, we're losing like two forces. We're losing Darius because he's moving across the street to do Michael Jackson. So honestly, we're not really losing him because I can wave from my dressing room. I can't say enough about how amazingly happy I am that I got to meet you on this show and got to work with you. Honestly, I will miss you, but I'm so freaking happy for you. So happy trails and cheers to Darius and Maria. Give them some love. I really can't wait for you all to see the new show once this hiatus is over and we're all back. I don't want to give away too much of the new stuff that we're doing. If you've seen the tour, you've seen a lot of it. But me and Laura Lee, we're super excited about being new dressing roomies, and she's just the sweetest, and we really have a tight bond with the new cast. So I'm really excited for us to get back together. And we've been texting a lot. We have a group chat, our entire cast, and we're all there for each other and just like super positive and motivating. We all have each other's back. So we went back to our dressing rooms, like I said, and rescued all of our plants, and we put everything away because they're gonna be deep cleaning the theaters. So we cleaned up. It was a good time, honestly, to go through my bins of crap that I have under my dressing station, and I brought home bags of unnecessary stuff that was in my dressing room. So probably a little overdue. And like I said, I saved all my plants, so they'll grow and be nice and strong when I get back, because we don't get a lot of sunlight in the dressing room, though I don't get a lot of sunlight here either. And our costume department covered up all of our costumes so that they are protected in this hiatus. The crew, took care of our stage and our set and our lights and everything so that our theater was nice and energy efficient while we have this time away. I have a lot of people asking, like, what is the deal with our Broadway actors getting paid? Are we getting, you know, what's happening? Honestly, we have no idea. That is what's insane about what's going on right now. This is something that has never happened, ever, obviously. So no one really knows what they're doing. No one really knows how to handle it, what the next step is. For right now, we, the producers and the Broadway League and our unions are working together to figure out a plan, and we trust them. We're all gonna figure out the best plan of attack for everybody involved. But you know, the entertainment industry is being hit really hard right now. We have no control over what is happening right now. So we're all trying to stay patient, trying to stay calm. I'm trying not to get too far ahead of myself and, you know, hunkering down and knowing that people are working really, really hard to take care of us and to make sure that we are protected within this time. And also, you know, doing the best for the show so the shows can continue succeeding after this time off. So everyone is working diligently together to do the best thing for all of us. So I really trust that, and I'm trying to stay patient and do what I can do. And if I find that there are things you can do to help or I can do to help, we should totally do them. So keeping my ears and eyes open, but we're all in good spirits. And I think, you know, it is, it, obviously we all have to make a living and make money, but I think that it, creatively, at least, it's been really, really incredible, incredible to watch our community, the Broadway community, come together and get creative, release songs, release podcasts, record videos. I find it truly inspiring, and this has been really fulfilling to me, and so I want to keep doing that. Focus, listen, stay safe, stay inside, and be really smart in this time. Until next time, everybody, see you soon. Next video coming up is gonna be a getting ready with me video, and then a Q&A, which I will open up very soon on my Instagram. Thank you for all the love and support. Like, subscribe. Bye-bye.